Hey guys, I'm the Sky Spy. Welcome back to my Let's Play Pikmin 2. Oh my god, the president. Hey guys, I'm the Sky Spy, and welcome back to my Let's Play Pikmin 2. Last time, we had a ball with the president. We had a ton of fun with Mr. President over here, who is filling up the gap that Louis went away. We are here back in the Wistful Wild, or rather in this new area, the Wistful Wild, to search for Louis, and we have come across this cavern, the Cavern of Chaos. And we've gotten invested for sub-level as well. Today, here we are in sub-level 2 with the amazing president. Do I need to stress his, car horn? So, today we're going to be going further down the Cavern of Chaos. Now, as we can see here, there are 3 fiery bulb axes. Let's take care of the swooping stitch bug. You might be thinking like, oh, okay, we'll just get your reds. The thing is, I brought in 20 of each color. And I don't know if just 20 reds is enough, and if I went in there with only 20 reds, I might end up with only 10. So, I'm actually going to use my bitter spray on this guy. Is that everybody swarmed? Oh! But the fire is still there? I did not know that. I did not know that fire hung around. Okay. That's news to me. Then, I guess have them jump on him. But this is gonna suck. Okay, come on. Yep, yeah, see, I can't do this. I can't fight. This is gonna suck. No! Sheesh. Come on, guys. I could, like, wait until he falls asleep again and then go in to fight him, but... Oh, he hit a white Pikmin. That's actually pretty amazing. I'm not gonna willingly sacrifice white Pikmin, though, because I do want them alive, ideally. Because there are poison hazards, as we've seen before, and I do want some Pikmin to... Come on. Eh. To, be able to work with that. Anyway, now we don't need to do anything special. Let's just finish them off. Okay, there we go. So I think, actually, all 3 of these fiery bulb axes actually all have a treasure. So, that's gonna be interesting. I'm also gonna hate that, because, oh my god... I'm not a fan of fiery bulb axes. I'm probably just bad at the game. I'm probably just gonna be playing. I'm probably just awful. I just run in right away. Gemstar wife, really? I just rush in. No holds barred. Run. So no, not smart. But hey. You know what? Sure. I'll use my bitter spray on this guy. I was scared for a second that it wouldn't actually go. Freaking, he's still on fire. That's ridiculous. Alright, come on. There we go. And this guy, let's just... Whoa, no. Did not mean to do that. Alright, come on. President, you have a heart of fire. You have a fiery heart that I adore. Oh, God. No. Eh? And we have a white. We have yellow. Okay. I guess I exactly don't have a right to adore his heart. I mean, then again, he has a lovely wife waiting for him at home. Sarcasm, sarcasm. Alright, let's see here. Let's, do this. Wake him up. Okay, now, get away. Wait, okay, he didn't need anybody. Hey, fall back asleep, you stupid. I mean, this isn't gonna work. I can't just, like, do this and wait until he wakes up, because as you can see, if we just kept that up, we'd literally do no damage to him. Okay, get back. Sheesh, man, I hate these guys. Come on. Sheesh, come on! Let's do this. I probably just suck. I think that's actually the case. Woo! Oh, I was wondering why you weren't doing so. Because there's more! I hate you! I really do not like you. I think now I'll just wait until you fall asleep and then finish you off. We only have 10 red Pikmin left, are you joking? I swear, if there's a way to get more red Pikmin, I really hope there is. Queen Candy Pop Bug getting reds right away. Come on, you don't see me. Fall back asleep. Go back to your stupid place. Ah! He can't make it past the Stitch Bug. Come on. Go back to sleep, you stupid. Yawn and die. Come on. There we go. God, I hate you. Okay. Yeah, that was not a good start because, oh my god, did not do very well fighting that guy. There's probably a smarter way to fight Fireball Blasts. I should actually probably like look up better methods of fighting those guys, because I am by no means good at fighting them. And do we? Oh my gosh, we almost have all Leaf Picker. That's actually pretty cool. Pretty cool. Alright, so that should be it. also guys, of course, since we've already repaid the debt, Pokos aren't that important to us anymore. But I mean, I'll still be collecting them. I mean, of course, you still want to get every single treasure you can find. It's not like that. But I mean, like, as for, like, making enemies come back to base, Essence of Despair, that looks legitimately really cool. But as for, like, carrying enemies back, there's, like, no point. There never has been a point, really, but I mean, you know. Alright, so let's see. Oh, what? Nope, didn't mean to do that. Come on, guys. Anyway, so I want to talk about this, something else. On the Mirror Skeptics, yeah, we're still doing the Pokemon Emerald Soul Link. We're just never gonna get to finish that. No, we're gonna hopefully finish it soon. Frosty Bobble. But I thought I said Frosty Bible. Ugh. However, we do have an idea of what our next Let's Play will be, and I'm looking forward to it. We were just talking about this yesterday. Last night, we were just saying, hey, what if we did this game for a new Let's Play? And it's a pretty good idea. We're both up for it. We were originally gonna do a Valve game. But we realized, like, recording that would be annoying for our equipment right now. I'm gonna get a new computer within the next couple of weeks, hopefully. But yeah, so we decided on another game, which I'm just fully fine with. So I hope you guys are looking forward to that. I know I haven't even told you what the game is, but yeah. Sub-level 3, let's see here. Whoa, buddy! You know what, just because we literally did not do anything, I'll reset. And I'm also going to show it on screen, just so that you guys can see how dumb I'm being. But probably not. God. I'm sorry, but I'll wimp out courageously, because that's a thing. And, just go ahead and just, you know, do that again. Alright, hold on. God, my old save file. No, I'm not going back to that anytime soon. Alright, come on. Oh, wow, we have a completely new sub-level. Completely new. Oh, okay, well, good to know that hasn't changed. Creeping Chrysanthemums. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I get it. There's Creeping Chrysanthemums here. Why are there so many? Come on, wake up, stupid. Oh, wow. God, these guys are so, they're not even hard to fight. They're just time-consuming. I don't like Creeping Chrysanthemums. They just take so long to beat. All right. Are you? No, you're not. No, you're not. Okay, come on. What do we have in here? I'm trying to... Oh, okay, fine. Looks like somebody's been laying a nest in here. Laying a nest. Yes, yes, out of your butt, a nest pops out. No, that's not what I meant. Then again, I wouldn't put it past the really weird creatures of this game. Alright, let's see. Next one is right here. Hey, buddy. Creeper Chrysanthemums aren't hard to deal with, it's just that they're just annoying. Like, oh my god. I mean, like, it's super easy to just deal with them without having a single Pikmin lost, but it's just so time-consuming. Alright. What do we have here? Oh, you know what? This boss that I'm about to fight, wow, I'm actually, not boss I'm about to fight, but the boss of the Cavern of Chaos, I just realized who the boss was. I'm not that bad at fighting it. Hey, President, can I introduce you to this, nice little potion trick? Think you'll enjoy it. Hey, bup. Alright. Look at that, they're both kissing the same girl. That's cute. No, that's weird. Come on. Come on, guys. All these yellows and whites. At least it wasn't the pink crew. God, why are there... Oh, check it out. Oh, okay. I wish that kind of landed on, like, the creepy chrysanthemum's face. That would have been fun. Ah, damn it. As soon as I'm talking about... Oh, it didn't need any Pikmin? Color me surprised. It really looked like it did. All right. No, what? Come on. I'll take that loss. I'll take that loss. That's ridiculous, though. Come on. Really? Now I'm doing awful. Okay, stop! Sheesh! I really hate this guy. Come on. I'm just swarming you right now. Okay, he even heard the president. No, Mamudas! Hey guys, how's it going? Is there any other way to go right now? Oh, come on! Okay. Oh! That's interesting. Why is there just a regular pepper here? Let's wake you up, but... regular green pepper? Just in the middle of nowhere? Sure, why not? Okay, hey, you're stupid. Nobody likes you. God. And especially not me. Come on. Come on! Yeah! I think I don't want to carry that thing back until we deal with the Mamudas. Ah, God, well, you're awake. You want to follow my Pikmin? No, actually, because then we'd have no one to beat you with. We actually want to... okay, let's kill one of you guys. Oh, damn it, you're both awake. Okay, come on. Kill him! Okay, good. Okay. One thing I want to mention is there is a treasure later in the game which, lets you just pluck all Pikmin in a given area instantly. Which is amazing treasure, especially for the Mamuda. Because the Mamuda, like, if it, like, squashes all of your Pikmin, it's gonna be very difficult to get enough Pikmin to deal with it again. But you know what, buddy? Here, hold on. I'm gonna throw all these Pikmin on you. And wow! Okay. Much easier way of dealing with them. Awesome. But I really do like the Mamuda. There's like so much, there's so many things to talk about it. I did say this in a caption in the first time when we encountered Mamuda. In the, I forgot what cave it exactly was. The Frontier Cavern, I think, right? Sub-level 5 of Frontier Cavern or something like that. But, one thing I want to mention about these guys is the fact that they actually, there's a theory going around, I don't even think it's a theory, I think it is actually, like, there is, like, some, like, legit evidence behind it, that the Mamuda is an adult version of the Smoky Prog. And the Smoky Prog is a very mythical creature from the first Pikmin game. Oh god, nobody likes that thing. It's very difficult to beat, but yeah. The Smoky Prog is what many people consider to be, like, a deformed larval Mamuda. Which is an interesting thing to think about, honestly. I mean, I know I like... wow, look at that. Choo-choo, the train's heading home. Look at that. Oh my god, with this one bell pepper just like moving through the crowd, like, hey, make way, make way. But yeah, it's pretty cool, honestly. I do like it. Anyway, so let's see here. Ching, ching, bing. The infernal vegetable! Oh, did like the ship like eat it and like see like, oh god, it's awful! Alright, let's get all these things back. Whoa! Where did those rocks land? Oh, did they just land right on Olimar's I think they just landed right on Olimar, that's amazing! Alright, let's see here. Oh wow, they pushed this thing back, okay. Alright, well yeah, only 7 Pokos, no real use, so... we'll press on. Actually, let's just do this. Double jump with the Pikmin? Yes. Gosh. These wistful wild dungeons, they're fairly tough compared to the others. Oh god, as soon as I say they're tougher than the others, we have water. What are those things? Oh, okay, got it. Yeah, those guys. Hold on. Let's deal with this first. Why is there always one Pikmin? This is actually nothing? I have a little bit of a hard time believing that. Hold on. Oh my god! Why did that terrify me? That's amazing. Why did that terrify me? I thought these flowers sprouted from the ground. Why did a queen candy bubble just come from the middle of nowhere? Okay, you know what? I'm not complaining. What do we have the least of? Besides reds, we have... do we seriously have even amounts? Oh, okay. Well, technically we have the most yellows, so... hey, yellows, look like you're being the ones being sacrificed again. For reds, where are you? There you are. Because we lost 10 reds on the previous floor, so... I mean, yeah. And, again, if there are any violet candy pop buds... we need 100 purple Pikmin to be able to get the last overworld treasure in the Wistful Wild. So we do need, I don't even know if we have 100 of any type. Maybe reds at one point, but yeah. Let's deal with this. Actually, let's play as the president, man. I wanna play as the president. You wanna play as the president of a Hogatate Freight? Bop. He's gonna punch these bombs in the face. Oh my god! Yeah, okay. I did not, Okay, hey, Emperor Bulblax, good to see you, buddy. You see this bomb over here? Can you, like, real quick eat this? Thank you. You're stupid. Oh my god. I'm sorry, yeah, I was wondering what these two stocks were, and then I said, oh yeah, I didn't want to spoil the surprise. But yeah, Emperor Bulblax is back. In the previous Pikmin game, a strategy for beating Emperor Bulblax was by making it eat bomb rocks. By throwing, yellows were the only ones who could hold bomb rocks back in that game. But yeah, you could get bomb rocks and make Emperor Bulblax eat a bomb rock, and that would just make it stunned, ready for your Pikmin to attack it. That was a big strategy for it. However, I actually should probably not be wasting these bomb rocks, since I actually should probably, hold on. Let's get Mr. President, who has no idea what Emperor Bulblax is, but yeah. Let's see here, let's do this, let's get our blues. All right. Now, bomb rock. Oh God, do not eat the, of course you eat them. All right, come on, eat it. It's good, tastes good, promise. All right, good. It's gonna eat this, gonna take a little bit of damage, but also stunned. All right, awesome. Yeah, I forgot about this thing, okay. Let's see, let's have this in the corner. Yeah, I actually used up so many more bomb rocks than I should have. We still have a ton over here, though. So, hey, Bulby. Love you, bro. Let's, bop. I was not ready for him to come out, let's just say that much. Alright, let's see, why do we only have 10 blues? That's weird. Alright, hold on. Oh god, please tell me you go after the captain and not the Pikmin. Hey, come on. Come on, go on. No. Wait, yes or no? I don't know which one it is. Hey, see these bombs? God, okay, make up your mind. You're surrounded by them. Make a choice. There, this one. There we go. I didn't even need to taunt you into eating it. You just did it. Come on, buddy. And you didn't really have a way of exploiting this in the first time that we fought Emperor Bulblax in this game. So it is cool that they actually kind of have this. I don't know about. Oh god, the roar. Okay. There you guys are. Okay. Let's see here. Are you just gonna walk through the fire like a bet? Yeah, you are. Alright, hold on. Hey. Come on. This is awesome. It tastes like coal. And I don't personally like it. It's not my preferred method of breakfast or dinner, dessert or anything. But hey, are you kidding? Are you really gonna? You're a jerk. Okay, you know what? Hold on. Alright, hey buddy. We're best friends. All right, turn around. Yeah, I'm right here. You're prey, you're best. Right here, buddy. Hey. Oh God, I probably shouldn't have done that. All right. But yeah, hey, okay, over here. I really do like the Emperor Bulblax. I mean, it's a lot less menacing than the first game, let's just say that much. It's a lot weaker and, will you eat it? Whoa, just barely. Throw these guys on his, is that enough? I don't know. That is enough. Awesome. And check it out. From beating the Emperor Bulblax, we have this sort of claw, this sort of crab claw. And right now, that might mean like very little to you. You'd be like, "What? What the heck? What crab claw? What is that supposed to mean?" Trust me, it's really, really cool. Later on, when you discover what this exactly means. Okay, I threw eight on there. Come on. Come on, guys. I actually should probably be throwing them around it. Come on! Thank you! Holy balls, okay. Can you actually? No, you can't, okay. But yeah, so just remember that. Emperor Bulblax one time ate a crab's claw. Just remember that. It's not as random as it sounds. But yeah, so I think that's actually it for this sub-level. We just had a little mini-encounter with Emperor Bulblax there, which I think is pretty fun, honestly. This calls for a whistle. Yeah, buddy. God, I'm sorry. I love that. All right. Alright, so here we go. We have the mysterious remains. Look at that. So what we have here is a crab claw. I know I'm making a really weird little assumption here, but let's just say the world connects. The world connects in really nice ways, and there's still something else. Oh, don't tell me there's buried treasure on this side. Okay, good, it's not on this. Oh, is it here? It's here, okay. Oh, okay. We have a yogurt. Hey guys. Got a little thing to show you. You hungry? Because, oh my god, those stupid things whenever, I actually can't call it stupid because I have done this sometimes, but whenever I was like, hey, you want this? Like, this candy or something, and they just give you the wrapper. Actually, I've seen that being done with drinks more than anything else, but god, whenever people do that, and I'm one of those people. I mean, it's not enough to fool anyone, of course, who would get fooled by that, but it's just so funny whenever people do it, because it's like, okay, you know what, you're an idiot. Because it's such a stereotypical thing by now. Alright, so, alright. It's good. What is... did you see in the credits how there was, like, so many brands, like, in the credits, like, of course, like, not the real credits, but the Louis being lost credits, the lost Louis credits. I think it's just so funny how it said, special thanks to all of these brands for letting your products be abandoned onto the planet of a Pikmin. Like, the fact that they didn't decide to milk tub? Is that like a butter? I think it's like, is that like a butter cup or butter cup? Yes, this is a butter cup. No, but I mean, is that what it is? Might be. I don't know. Either way, though, let's head down further. But yeah, I did love how they didn't even they couldn't just reference them. No. They just straight up had the treasures, and I just think that's really funny. All right, so here we go. Cavern of Chaos, sub-level 5. This sub-level is actually, if I'm not mistaken, a rest level. Yeah. So, yes it is. Awesome. No treasure, just Queen Candy Pop Buds, a Violet, and an Ivory. And is there anything else here? Don't think so. Yeah, this is a Oh, no, I didn't mean to come here without Pikmin. Come on, guys. We got an Iridescent Flint Beetle. Come on, yeah, buddy, there's one. Oh, there's two over here. Come on, hey, get him. I probably should focus on one before the other, but, damn it, we're gonna go on both then. Where'd it go? Okay, well, we're focusing on one, I guess. Come on. I want to knock the spray out of you. There you go. Okay, where's the other one? Hopefully it hasn't disappeared. There it is. Hey, buddy. There it is. Little flint beetle. There we go. I don't know where the spray went, but... Oh, there, evidently. What is it? It's spicy. Okay. I'm actually kind of hoping for bitter spray now, because I'm using it a lot. Like, I guess immobilizing enemies I never found to be as useful as it actually is. I wish I had, like, 20-something of them. Alright, come on. There we go. Now I'm just using it, like, normally. Like, every single time you see a spray, just do the trick, because it's awesome. Alright, we have all this, actually, let's not use this yet. Let's see here. First of all, let's sacrifice... Well, no. Wow, I say it, like, such an evil thing. What do we want to use this queen for? I'll convert yellow. Yeah, I'm doing yellows, because you only get rid of one yellow. It's not like... Oh, crap. Okay, good. Yeah, I want them to turn to blues, since we keep on having an abundance of yellows and not that many reds and blues. And I think that's because, like, reds and... Or, I guess more specifically, blues coming to so many different puzzles of just going underwater, exploring a whole new area that other Pikmin can't. But, I mean, you know. Now, we'll toss 5 blues into here, because we, as I said before... Really need purple Pikmin. Okay, that was good. And should we use the ivory? Yeah. We'll throw 5 reds into the ivory. I'll do that. The ivory. So yeah, this is a really nice rest level, and I forgot about Queen. I forgot the Queen Candy Pop Buds actually give you more than what am I trying to say? Oh god, no! No! Well, I'm a moron, I just converted purples. Watch me have 97. No! Okay. I am sorry, do you know what? Freaking... Okay, there's still more. Just stop being an idiot. Holy crap. Okay, come on. You got this, guys, I believe in you. To an extent, come on. Sorry, that freaked me out. God, I need purple Pikmin. I need more purple Pikmin. I need more cowbell. No, I need more purple Pikmin. And I referenced that out of all things. Wow. Hey, who cares? I like that. I like that. I really just. Hey, guy, I've got a fever. I've got a fever, and the only what was it? Antidote? Not the only antidote. And the only prescription is more cowbell. If you know what that's from. I don't blame you if you don't. It's hilarious, though. This looks like a big sub level. Alright, let's see what we have here. Oh yeah, I remember that. Okay, so what was that? What did I just see? Whoa, look! Come on, dude! You could stand to be a little more polite. Oh my god. I was like, what did I see over there? It's like a horror movie, like, Wallywog! Okay, I see you there, and I do not want to have to deal with you while I'm taking care of the electric gate. Hold on. I'm gonna get these purples out. These purples are gonna be the end. Come on. Okay, come on. Hey, yeah, you're stunned. You're stunned. You bet you're stunned, because purple pigments are the DD that I just threw whites into the water. I meant to do that. Alright, fine, didn't mean to do that, it's dumb. What do we have here? More festivities. The Princess Pearl, aww. Aww, it's adorable! Alright, let's see, what do we have here? Wow, why did I slow down the process for no reason? Okay, so let's get our yellow, since this looks like a yellow. Oh wait, the blue's, okay, whatever. This looks like a yellow party. I see anode beetles all over the place and water dumples, oddly enough. Okay, so let's do this, let's take care of this. I think I'll just, have the captain hang out. The captain? Yeah, the president. I'll have the president hang out here while we deal with all the electricity first of all. Okay, that's an anode beetle in the water. What do you want me to do about that? No. Just a no. That's what I'm gonna do about it. Are there any other electric gates around here? Okay, where's the treasure, actually? That's a better question. I was gonna say, if you actually manage to eat one of the Pikmin. Oh, there. Okay, that's a job for water Pikmin. Do not actually- he ate one. Dude, I'm done. Oh, that's actually a really interesting treasure. Okay, we'll- actually, this is a yellow Pikmin job, actually. Hold on. You guys, get over here. Get you over- oh, what? Okay. That makes sense. Anode beetles can't hurt you, so I'm not worried. Okay, no. Can we throw you high enough? We can. Oh, I'm an idiot, I'm a moron. Ugh, okay. Yeah. I don't think we lost anybody, though, which is awesome and very, very surprising. So we're just gonna have to hope that no anode beetles, like, hit us with electricity. And it's a lot worse of a threat than it usually is, because, remember, electricity is instant death. Alright, there we go. You know, electricity, you can't whistle people back from it. No, if they get electrified, if they get electrocuted, that's it. No, let's see. Oh, God. Do you just have to be in that spot? Okay, let's... Sure, I'll deal with you with yellow. Oh, God. This is what you get for murdering that one yellow! Alright, and then... open spot. For the... This is what you get for just being there in general! Yes! Okay. This is a job for yellow Pikmin. That treasure up there, what I'm trying to say. Because, because the anode... What the heck? Okay, that was weird. Let's do this. Throw you guys over. Back through that beetle, which shouldn't be a problem. Alright, so we're good. That should be the only other treasure, I'm hoping. I'm hoping. Ow! God! What the heck? What is he connected with? Oh, that one? Are you kidding? This one in here. How are you what? And did he just walk through the wall? Okay, no. Okay, no, he didn't. Okay, fine. I'm fine. Alright. just the president's just like so salty. Okay, no. You know, one day I am going to bring a fake salt shaker to school. Or just in public. I'm gonna bring a fake salt. Oh, I guess I can't really do it in public, but I'm gonna bring a fake salt shaker with. Oh, I'm an idiot! Okay, Wii Remote, work! He's dead. Yeah. For some, my Wii Remote was like aiming up for something. What the heck? Okay, that was weird. Anyway. Alright, that's it! Groshroom. Groshroom. Alright, that's actually a pretty big cap on mushroom. Burp. Alright guys, so that's about it for today. Hope you guys enjoyed. That was level 6. We are more than halfway done with the Cavern of Chaos. Hasn't been too bad of a sub-level. I mean, that one fiery Bulblast floor was, of course, awful. But hey, we've been measuring to get our way through here pretty well. And anyway, guys, hope you guys enjoyed. Next time, we're going to be hopefully completing the Cavern of Chaos. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more on Pikmin and all other things Nintendo. I'm the Sky Spire, and until then...